Compared to previous generations, they spend a lot more time communicating with their friends electronically, and they also spend less time hanging out with their friends in person.
Gen Z are the type of people to see a house fire, but instead of helping, they go and record it and post it on their TikTok and then put in their bio, hashtag stop all house fires. So today I just wanted to...
I have no further hope for Generation Z.
Generation Z, they're sound to be the saddest, loneliest, and most mentally fragile age group to date.
I'm so tired of hearing people say that we are a lost generation. Have you ever heard a saying that the current generation is long lost, or in my time, kids these days? I completely don't understand why some people think like that. Of course, quite often modern boys and girls are called digital people because they have an addiction to smartphones and tablets from an early age. They cannot imagine their life without technology. But at the same time, representatives of Generation Z are in many ways looking at the world from the same angle as teenagers of another time, experiencing the same difficulties, and are also trying to find themselves. So that is why it's not correct to single out Generation Z calling it lost. Once I saw a text dedicated to the current generation, I was quite surprised because all that was written there was how we spend all our time on social networks, we can live without our phones, or we just can't communicate in real life. And this is not first case because many articles write that we bring constant problems. For example, the first stereotype is that Generation Z is lazy and doesn't want to do anything for the future. Well, are we sure that this is true? According to research by Robert Half, a psychologist, it found that 77% Generation Z believe that they will need to work harder to compare to those in past generations to have a satisfying and fulfilling professional life. You know, a couple of days ago, I asked my friend if he was free to meet with me to go somewhere. He said, "Oh no, today I have extra class, swimming classes, dancing classes, then I do my homework, then I go to sleep. It won't work out anyway today, sorry." I was like, "Wow, how does he manage to do everything?" Later on, I saw an article how one boy scored all the points on the exam. So that means he wrote the exam without a single mistake. And it turns out that we are lazy. Lumping the whole generation together as lazy while many of us are working very hard for our future. Another thing I would like to say is that many people consider this generation too stubborn and persistent. They say we like to argue. Well, it can be explained. Generation Z wants to be able to share their opinions, their thoughts. It could be anywhere, at school, at work, and so on. And it doesn't mean that we only want to tell our opinion, but it means that we truly believe that each voice is important and should be heard. With technology, Generation Z have been able to connect to faraway cultures, issues, news, earlier and more often than any generation before them. As a result, Generation Z tend to be more open-minded, liberal-leaning, and actively engaged for advocating for the fair and for equal treatment of others. This generation participates in public events such as environment programs or charity projects. So this generation thinks not only about themselves, but also about the whole world. And the last, the most popular stereotype is that we only communicate online or we just can't hold attention. Yeah. Of course, it's a problem that we cannot perceive information more than 100 words, but with technology, Generation Z to grow up on gadgets and the internet, but it's not a bad sign. New technologies open new ways. For example, because of the virus, people started working from home using only computers, right? Need answers to your questions? All the information is on your phone. So overall, the internet and our gadgets give us more opportunities. So, advancement of technology has its downside, of course. We were born in an age when a huge number of people are losing their job due to the emergence of so-called smart means of production. Many production facilities and industries will be closed in the future because of artificial intelligence. The list of occupations in demand are changing so fast. So that major you choose in the first year of college might be already outdated by the time you get your degree. So this leads us to look for new and different ways of pursuing education. Just going to university is not enough for us. We want hands-on skills to travel, courses, exchange programs. So this makes us look like we aren't serious about education. But we just don't want to throw our 20s into pursuing one degree. Or maybe we just want to have the freedom of pursuing new alternative way for life. So are we a lost generation? Or are we just a little lost in this rapidly changing world, looking for new solutions to new challenges that no other generation had to face? We are the first generation that uses computers in the homes and schools. Honestly, I can't imagine how people live without phones, without such availability to almost everything right now. We can use this as our advantage. Being tech-savvy from a young age gives our generation every opportunity to create something new for the world. I'm sure you've seen some articles about young people presenting their new invention or young people breaking world records. There are many cases of young people meeting the needs of this world through their creative solution. Let me show you some examples, such as Amber Young, 19 years old, developed a program that can predict the position of space junk with 98% accuracy. Peyton Robertson, 17 years old, found a non-profit for STEM education. Jack Ngaka, 15 years old, created a sensor test for cancer. In my peers, I often can see creative people who have so many different ideas that they want to bring to life. They inspire me to think out of the box, look for alternative solutions to change the world for the better. So don't look at us as a lost cause, but as a creative allies making the world a better place for all of us. Thank you.